What's up, Life Kids? We're so excited to have you joining us today. This whole month, we're going to talk about breaking news. We're going to talk about the prophets in the Old Testament and the news that they brought to the people of Israel. So sit back. Actually, don't sit back. Stand up and let's do some worship this morning.
Everywhere I go, I will lift your name up. In all I do, I will give you praise. Everywhere I go, I will lift your name up. I lift your name up. month, we're talking about breaking news. Have you ever heard of fake news? Fake news is news that isn't real or might not have happened, but gets posted everywhere, and so you think that it's real, you're not really sure. So we're gonna play a quick little game, and you can play along as well while you're at home. So I'm gonna read something off, and if you think that the news is fake, you put a thumbs down. And if you think the news is real, you're gonna give me a thumbs up, okay? And y'all are gonna do the same. Are y'all ready?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Yes, I'm ready now. Okay.
Give me a thumbs up. Let me see. Okay, thumbs down. All right, just making sure you knew what thumbs up and thumbs down was. Okay, here we go. A chihuahua that can't walk makes friends with a bird that can't fly. Real or fake?
That's real, yeah.
Wow, Jake actually got it right this time. If you had a thumbs up, that's real news. Are you ready for the next one?
Yeah.
A 12-year-old dog graduates college. I haven't even done that yet.
Thumbs down.
They both got it right. If you had a thumbs down, that's fake news.
Two for two.
You ready for the next one?
Yeah.
Man arrested for using his phone while riding a horse. Real or fake?
I'm gonna say that, yeah.
Wow, good job. All right, Jake's 3 for 3. That's a shocker. If you said real news, that's real news. Are you ready for the next one?
Yep.
Cold weather in Florida can cause iguanas to fall from trees. Is that real or fake?
I think that's real.
The cold weather in Florida causes iguanas to fall from trees.
I read that in a book somewhere.
And Jake's right. If you said that was real, you got it right. Oh my gosh. All right, this is the last one. Let's see. It's about a baby, so you're probably gonna get it wrong.
True.
10-month-old baby becomes first ever county sheriff. What did I say? He got it wrong. That is fake news. Let's go check out Callie's vlog to see what she has to say.
Hello, friends. Welcome back, friends. Today has got to be the worst day in, like, forever. Why? Well, it's raining, which means I can't go outside to play. Allie, Chip, and I were supposed to go get my favorite vanilla ice cream with sprinkles and whipped cream and with the second best topping ever made, peanuts. Well, maybe we can hang out anyway. I'll just give them a... It's Gabrielle from school. She probably wants to hang out, but I really want to hang out with Chip and Allie today. Should I answer? Okay, let me see what my friend Allie is doing, though. Maybe she's busy. And look, friends, Gabrielle is calling again. I don't know what to do. I'll just ignore it. Let me call Chip. Yeah, I'll call Chip. Oh, wow. No answer from Chip either. I'll just wait for them to call me back. It's Gabrielle again. I guess I should answer. Hello?
Hey, Callie, I was just calling you. I wanted to know if you would come play with me after the rainstorm.
That's really nice, but I'm kind of busy. Maybe another time?
Oh, okay, no problem. Allie and Chip are here, so maybe we can all play next time.
Huh? They're there? All three of you together? That sounds like fun! Actually, could I come over?
But you said you were kind of busy.
Yeah, I was, but I'm not anymore. It would be so much fun to hang out with Allie, Chip, and you.
Oh, I see. Well, I gotta run now, Callie. You can come by later.
Okay, friends, I don't know what to do. I like Gabrielle, but I'm more excited about seeing Allie and Chip. But I feel bad about only going over because I found out they were there. What do you think I should do? Should I go hide in my room until the rain passes? Or should I listen to today's Bible story?
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Kane's Mamma Mia!
And these are your breaking news.
I could see your big eyeballs.
It's time for a Bible story. A long time ago, there was a prophet named Amos. Amos was
very, very sad.
Why was he sad, you might ask?
He was sad because once again, because God's people were not living in a way that showed they loved God and loved others.
They stopped caring about people, but at the same time, they would sing to God, but their worship did not please God.
Oh no, because God didn't want people to worship only using words and singing songs. Worshiping God means more than that.
When people would say they loved God, they needed to show that by obeying God. Like loving others, God wanted their worship to be sincere.
Like this.
Mamma mia.
Sincere, not fake. In other words, we don't say one thing and do another.
Like lie.
God wanted the people to love God, to love people, but to also say and actually mean it with their action. If we say we love one another and that we love God, our actions should match.
When we are sincere, we are being honest and open about what we are thinking and feeling. We aren't hiding our real thoughts, but saying them to each other. We can be sincere with others and especially with God. And that's what God wanted the people to know through the prophet Amos. See you next time, Mamma Mia!
Wow, that Bible story made me realize that I wasn't really sincere with Gabrielle. I shouldn't have ignored her calls or told her I was busy when I really wasn't. Or say that I would go over just because I found out that my other friends were there. That's not a kind thing to do. But now I'm embarrassed. She'll probably forget about it, right? Or should I call and apologize? You got it.
Hey, Callie, where are you?
This movie is so cool. You gotta watch it.
Hey, Gabrielle. I wanted to say sorry to you.
What? Why?
I wasn't sincere to you. I didn't mean to ignore you earlier, but it's just that I had really hoped to hang out with Allie and Chip today. That's why I said I couldn't come over. But when I found out they were both at your house, I changed my mind. You're a good friend, and I should have told you what was going on.
Oh, thank you, Callie. That means a lot, and it's okay. We don't have to hang out all the time. I totally get it.
Okay, so I'll chat with you later, all right?
You don't want to come by?
Nah, you guys already started the movie anyway. Let's hang out next week. Tell Allie and Chip I said hi.
Oh, I will.
See ya!
See ya, Gabrielle. So, friends, that took a lot. But I'm happy I did that. Look, here we have a comment from Jack. Hey, Callie. So in order to be sincere, does that mean I need to sing louder in church? Hi, Jack. Thanks for your question. I don't think that's all of it. Sincere is all about meaning what you say. So yeah, because we love God, we can sing loud to show it. But more than that, if we say we love God, we need to show that by how we treat everyone. I learned that the hard way. Now, I know that I can be honest and sincere with my friends. Same thing for when I'm with my family. I can be sincere. And most importantly, when I worship God, I can be sincere. All of us can be sincere with a little help and practice. Speaking of friends, thanks for being here and growing with me every week.
Hey, Life Kids. So you know what time it is. It is time to go over our scripture verse. You all know the drill. I'm going to go over the time and I'm going to have you scream it to me as loud as you can. Okay, here we go. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be courageous. Be strong. 1 Corinthians 16:13. You know what to do. Everybody stand up. Get some air in your lungs. Let's go over it. Be on your guard.
Be on your guard.
Stand firm in the faith.
Stand firm in the faith.
Be courageous.
Be courageous.
Be strong.
Be strong.
1 Corinthians 16:13.
13.
All right, here we go. One more time. Be on your guard.
Be on your guard.
Stand firm in the faith.
Stand firm in the faith.
Be courageous.
Be courageous.
Be strong.
Be strong.
1 Corinthians.
1 Corinthians.
16.
16.
Dot, dot.
Dot, dot.
13.
13.
All right. I heard you were loud, but this time I need you to scream it as loud as you can. Just get somewhere where you can scream. Parents, I'm sorry. It's going to get a little loud, okay? Here we go. Be on your guard.
Be on your guard.
Stand firm in the faith.
Stand firm in the faith.
Be courageous.
Be courageous.
Be strong.
Be strong.
1 Corinthians.
1 Corinthians.
16.
16.
Dot, dot.
Dot, dot.
13. That was fantastic, guys. I love this verse and what this verse means. So now we're going to enter into a time of worship. So I want you to find somewhere in your house, get somewhere where you can be alone with just you and God, and we're going to worship God through this video.
Ooh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers, far and
it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's
It's who I am, Lord God. You are perfect in all of your ways. Who you are, who you are, and I love you. You are perfect in all of your ways. Who I am, who I
This just in. My name is Carl, and you are my little chicken nuggets. And today, it's gonna be a great day.
Welcome to Grill TV! Hosted by Carl, where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome.
Hey there, kiddos. So glad you tuned in today. We have a lot to talk about. But first, I want to go over something that's very exciting. Do you know how many words there are out there? I mean, there's literally hundreds and thousands of words out there in the universe. And we don't even use half of them or even know about them. Don't believe me? Let's play a game called What's That Word? I'll read a word aloud, and you have to guess what it means. Ready? Let's get it. The first word is bumfuzzle. Bum. Bum. Okay. This sounds like a word we would describe if we sat down on a chair too hard. Or maybe the funny last name of a football player. Let's see what it actually means. Bumfuzzle, to be flustered, confused, or perplexed. Ha! How cool is that? I get bumfuzzled all the time. Our next word is gardaloo. Man, that's a fun one. If I were to guess what this word was, I would say it's either a city in England, the feeling you get when you're picked first in a game, or the name of a group of flamingos. Let's see what gardaloo actually means. Gardaloo is a Scottish phrase one would yell out the window before throwing their old slop out. Could you imagine just walking down the road and all of a sudden you hear, gardaloo, and you look up and you see 4-week-old haggis and mashed potatoes. Gardaloo is a Scottish phrase one would yell out the window.
All right,
before last throwing word. Their old slop out.
This word isn't as funny.
What?
I read it this
That's
morning
crazy.
And it drove me crazy trying to figure out what it meant.
The word is sincere. Sincere. Now, when I first read it, I jumped back in my chair because I figured it had to be a bad word, considering the word starts off with the word sin. You see, I don't know if this word is a good word, a bad word, or a funny word like bumfuzzle. I just don't know.
Hey, Carl.
Hey, Cassie. How's it going?
Pretty good. What are y'all up to?
Well, we're trying to figure out what this word means.
What word is that?
Sincere, because I'm 130% certain that it is a bad word.
I can assure you it's not.
Cassie! It has the word sin in it. How do you explain that?
Well, I guess I can't, but the word means to be honest and genuine.
Could you use that in a sentence?
All right. When Amos was talking in Amos chapter 5...
Oh, I still don't get it.
You see, in that time, Amos was a prophet, and the people of Israel weren't loving and worshiping God like they were supposed to.
They weren't? How so?
They probably thought they were worshiping God in the right way because they sang songs of praise and gave offerings to God.
Is that not worship? I mean, of course that's not. Why don't you go ahead and explain to everybody why that would not be worship per se?
Well, it is worship, but in their case, it wasn't real. The people in Amos's day would worship God and say how much they love God, but then their lives didn't show that they love God at all.
Oh, I see what you mean. Because worship isn't about what we just say, it's about what we do.
Yeah, exactly. When we say we love God in our worship, we have to back that up with our actions. That includes being kind to others and generally trying our best to live in a way that pleases God.
Wow, so worship isn't just about what we do at church. It's about how we live our lives?
Yep, and that's where the word sincere comes in. We show that we're sincere when what we say matches what we do.
Being sincere sounds awesome. I'm gonna try to be more sincere with everyone. But the most important thing is, when I worship God, I can be sincere.
Hey, Carl, that's our big idea.
This just in, that's our big idea.
Today's big idea is, when I worship God, I can be sincere.
So let's say it all out loud on the count of three. Ready? One,
two,
three. When I worship God, I can be sincere. Yeah. Oh, I can be sincere, and so can you. And Cassie, too. Sincere! Well, thanks for the help today, Cassie.
No problem. I love having the chance to hang out with my favorite Flibbertigibbet.
Excuse me?
You've never heard that word before?
No. That's not a word, is it? It can't be. Is it? Flibbertigibbet? 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 Flibbertigibbet?
Thanks for watching, kids. See you next week.
Flibbertigibbet.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of RoTV!
All right, so this week, we've kind of been talking about Amos. Now, we're reading from Amos chapter 5 today, verses 18 through 25. So if you want to go read that with your parents, you can go ahead and read that. But I have some breaking news. It's not the best news that you're going to hear from one of the prophets. He actually says some pretty scary things, some pretty, you know, he says how terrible it will be. It's kind of scary, you know. I'll let you read that with your parents. You know, we've kind of heard about it. So basically what was happening in this book of the Bible is that Amos was talking to all of these people who were disobeying God and not living their lives the right way. They were sinning and not obeying God and doing all these terrible things. And Amos was basically telling them about how Jesus is going to return someday. And they needed to get their hearts right, because if their hearts weren't in the right spot, they weren't going to go to heaven. And hey, look around. Jesus could come anytime now. So are you ready for Jesus to come back? Now, today, we're going to be talking about when we worship, we can be sincere. Now, sincere is kind of a big word, so let's break that down and figure out what it means. Now, Carl kind of talked about that in the last video. You know, he kind of thought it was a bad word, but it's actually a good word. And what it means is to be true and real and genuine. So we need to be sincere when we worship. Well, what's the opposite of that? The opposite of that is when we're being fake. Just like we talked about earlier, there was fake and real news. Sometimes when we worship, we can be fake because we want the people around us to think that we're being good. We're more concerned about what people see rather than what God sees. So I have this water bottle, which represents you and I. Now, nothing special to it, it's just water. I just took the label off of it. And then I have this food coloring, if I can get the top off. So when we dump this food coloring in the water, hold on, let's get it in there. It's blue. Hold on, let me shake it up real good. So when we shake it up and we look at the water bottle, is it clear anymore? It's blue, right? So when we're sincere, we have to be complete. We have to be fully one thing and not the other. When we look at this water bottle, we don't have clear water and blue water. All we have is blue water. And that's what sincere is being like. You can't be half fake and half real. If you're going to worship God, you have to really worship God and be sincere when you do it. And there are different ways we can worship God, like reading the Bible and praying and singing songs and giving Him thanks. So when we do those things, we have to be sincere. We have to be real. We can't be fake too. You can't be more than one thing at one time. Now, another word for sincere is wholehearted. Now, if you go to our Facebook page, there are printables that you can print out at home. And this is also one of the printables that you can use. So it's just a heart, and it looks like a little bit like a little puzzle. So if we want to be sincere, we have to be wholehearted about worshiping God. Now, what you might want to do is you want to cut this piece of paper up and maybe glue it to some, you know, pretty construction piece of paper. You know, I chose red because it was a heart, you know, red, love, you know, all that. And on each puzzle piece of the heart, write thoughts, feelings, actions, and words. Because these four things, if we're not careful and we're not sincere about each of these things, if our actions don't match what we say, then we're not being sincere. So this is a good reminder that we can worship God and be sincere, which is our big idea for this week. Our big idea says that when I worship God, I can be sincere.
Thanks for joining us today, Life Kids. Remember this week, stay away from the real news and get your news from the Word of God. We'll see you next week. Bye. Yeah.